Mienet.
Okay, let's talk to Vesemir then. Yeah, they're the guys who look like trouble, huh?
Yennefer jest w Wizimie. Mam tam paru znajomych, więc... Coś nie tak? Rozejrzyj się. Będzie awantura.
Hello, Bart. Still doing good, still doing good. How are you?
Co to za jedni?
Patrioci piją siódmą kolejkę za Temerię i już ich pięści świerzbią.
Nie widzę tu Nilfgaardczyków.
Kogoś sobie znajdą. Kupię prowiant na drogę i jedziemy. Geralt, nie mieszajmy się. Ten jeden raz.
Co się stało z tarczą?
Zdjęłam.
Zdjęłaś? Może złote słońce zawiesisz?
Nie mogę tu mieć temerskich barw. Jeszcze przyjdą i karczmy spalą.
Może to prawda, co gadają.
That's pretty late, Bart. Who are you texting with?
Nilfgaardzka kurwa.
Puszczę to w niepamięć, Litka, bo wiem, że ci żal serce toczy.
Gówno wiesz. Powiesili mi siostrę. Wywlekli ją przed klasztor jak psa. Powiedzieli, że w Nilfgaardzie nie ma miejsca na zabobony. Że gniewu boskiego się nie boją. A ty? Nie boisz się? Gdyby nie Anulka, dzieciak by ci się pępowiną zabusił. Masz syna, bo cię siostra w połogu pilnowała. Nie boisz się gniewu boskiego? Nie boisz się, ty suko! Zostaw mnie!
She's intense about to marry, ah? Thanks for the host.
Znacie ten medalion, ludzie. Wiecie, co oznacza. Odstąpcie.
Cała jesteś?
Ludzie, mówią, że wiedźminy dzieci porywają.
Co wam cesarz obiecał, odmieńcy, co? Może państwo własne, jak drzewiej elfom?
Precz stąd wszyscy!
My nigdzie nie idziemy.
Wy też zostajecie.
Oni już się nie cofną.
Widzę.
Uh-oh. There's a fight. Yeah, burn. Get wrecked.
Już dobrze, po wszystkim.
It's a lot of blood spilled. I do really like this scene, though.
Odejdź stąd i nie wracaj nigdy.
No to tyle z niemieszaniem się. Chodźmy.
Really shows what this kind of violence can do, even though it's with good intentions, I guess. Not today, Bart. Not today.
To nie myśmy zaczęli tę burdę.
Wymówki, wymówki. Całe te.
I... Yennefer? Jak?
Dostałam raport, że w Białym Sadzie pojawił się Wiedźmin. Wiedziałam, że to ty. Że jedziesz moim tropem. Mogłam poczekać, aż mnie znajdziesz. Ale wiesz, cierpliwość nigdy nie była moją mocną stroną. Dobrze cię widzieć, Geralt. Jeszcze lepiej byłoby cię uścisnąć. Gdyby nie to, że jesteś cały we krwi.
Wybacz, nie spodziewałem się ciebie. Szczerze mówiąc, to w ogóle nie tak wyobrażałem sobie to spotkanie.
Mhm, a jak?
Bez obstawy Nilfgaardczyków, jak mniemam. Yennefer, nie zrozum mnie źle. Też się cieszę, że cię widzę. Ale jesteś nam chyba winna wyjaśnienia.
Udzielę ich, ale już w Wyzimie. Szykujcie konie.
Yeah, he's acting a bit headlessly, isn't he? Well, yeah. It's, sorry to hear you're tired, Bart, but I hope you had a good time with your American friends. So we're meeting Yennefer again, and she's obviously in tow of a Nilfgaardian group of soldiers here. Or she has them in tow, I guess. Which is interesting, Yennefer working with the Nilfgaardians. What apologies or what explanations does she have? Why Wizima? What's the rush?
Ostatnie 6 miesięcy spędziłem w siodle. Nie widziałem cię od 2 lat, więc o ile czas nie goni.
Niestety goni.
Oh, burn.
Ktoś na ciebie czeka, Geralt. Ktoś, kto czekać nie lubi. Cesarz Emhyr far Emreis. Dla przyjaciół biały płomień tańczący na kulchanach wrogów.
Wątpię, żeby zaliczył mnie do tego grona. Kiedy się ostatnio widzieliśmy, chciał mnie zabić.
Cóż, a teraz chcę ci złożyć propozycję.
Z gatunku tych nie do odrzucenia.
Ja nie odrzuciłam, choć mogłam.
No dobrze, mogę wysłuchać, co ma do powiedzenia.
Mhm. Cesarz Nilfgaardu, senior Metine, Ebing Higamere, suweren Nazairu i Vicovaro na pewno poczuje się zaszczycony.
Ach. A ty?
A ja pojadę w drugą stronę. Zdaje
she
się,
has such a reverence for titles and power.
Poza tym mam co robić. Ker Moren.
I hate Julian.
Tak, pamiętam. Dzięki za pomoc. I do zobaczenia.
Jak twój koń? Szybki jest?
Nie narzekam. Czemu pytasz?
Chciałabym wrócić za solidne miejskie mury tak szybko, jak to możliwe.
Goodbye.
Znając ciebie, to pewnie był nieprzyzwoity.
Tylko na początku, a potem...
A potem?
But then the wild hunt.
Galo! Już!
Pogadamy o tym jutro, dobrze? Po audiencji.
Dobrze.
W poszukiwaniu Yennefer, swej dawnej miłości, Geralt trafił w pobliże wsi Biały Sap. Zdawało się, że czarodziejka wyprzedza Wiedźmina tylko o krok, ale cały czas pozostawała nieuchwytna. W końcu, dzięki komendantowi nilfgaardzkiego garnizonu, Geralt dowiedział się, że Yennefer przebywa w Wyzimie.
And Geralt's in a tub again. Doesn't look too comfortable. Oh, Merrid. Our old buddy, the gentleman, stinks.
Może być.
Do you just call us bitch?
Myślisz, że Emhyra obchodzi, co mam za uszami?
Wasz mość raczy mówić o cesarskiej mości, używając pełnego tytułu albo wcale.
O, no,
wasz mość zasiądzie na berżerze.
Berżerze.
Na czym?
Na tym krześle.
He gets bitten the other time he's in a bath.
Kledwin, proszę waszmość ogolić baczki na pół cala.
No, not my beard.
Niech będzie. A co później? Zrobicie mi paznokcie?
Jeśli czas pozwoli. Proszę wybaczyć, ale lista zabiegów pielęgnacyjnych, którym waszmość należałoby poddać, jest długa, a dzień krótki.
Proszę odchylić głowę i nie ruszać się.
Jak przygotowania do audiencji? Wszystko zgodnie z planem?
Tak, wasza wielmożność. Waszmość będzie się jakoś prezentować.
A ty coś za jeden. Też jakiś bal wiesz?
Nie. Morvran Vorhis, dowódca dywizji Alba. Tej, do której należeli żołnierze z obstawy Yennefer. Właśnie. Należeli. Żaden z nich nie wrócił do Wyzimy. Ciekaw jestem, co dokładnie stało się wczoraj na gościńcu. Może mi opowiesz? Masz w końcu trochę czasu. I brzytwę na gardle.
Morvran's voice was one of my favorite voice actors in the English version, actually. I don't like his voice here too much. Your men died in battle as soldiers. Do you, Wild Hunt, kill them?
Zabił ich dziki gon.
Orszak upiorów, który jeździ po nocnym niebie? Zwiastuny wojny, o których bajają wieśniacy? Geralt. Myślisz, że w to uwierzę?
Szczerze mówiąc, mam to gdzieś.
Nordlingowie. Można was umyć, ostrzyc i ubrać, ale nauczyć manier to będzie wyzwanie.
Mnie też było miło poznać.
Skończone. Golić drugi raz pod włos?
Nie. Nie trzeba. Jego lepiej pod włos nie brać. Żegnaj, Wiedźminie. Albo raczej do zobaczenia.
Do zobaczenia.
Dobrze. Teraz waszmość raczy się odziać.
The gentleman may dress.
Niestety nie miałem dokładnych wymiarów waszmości. Jeśli będzie uwierać, krawiec naniesie poprawki.
Hi, Aquatic. What do I think of the English vs. Polish voice acting overall? I understand next to nothing as well. I know a couple of words in Polish, like dobrze and dziękuję, and tak, and you know, that kind of stuff. I do like Geralt's voice quite a bit. I love Geralt's voice in the English version as well, so there's that. But I do like it in the Polish even better, probably. The other ones I'm not too sure about. I mean, they're all good. But I think there were some very, very excellent voices in the English voiceover. I loved Lien's voice. I also loved Morvran's voice. Those were probably my two favorite voice actors. And, yeah, I think I like them better than the Polish ones. Why is it in Polish? Because the game's from Poland, and that's the original voiceover. Where's my clothes?
Gdzie moje ubrania?
Tam, gdzie powinny były znaleźć się dawno temu. U praczki.
Yeah.
Dostaniecie je po audiencji. Czyste i nakrochmalone. Waszmość niech oznajmi, kiedy się namyśli co do stroju.
They say kurwa all the time, the bandits, don't they?
Szkoda, że nie mam czasu.
Morvran Vorhis.
Może to dla waszmości nowum, ale przewiązany na biodrach ręcznik nie jest strojem stosownym do audiencji.
Oh, but I like my towel. Exactly. Of course we're gonna take all of them, because, you know, free stuff. Also, I'm gonna steal all their books. Wait, can I loot this dresser? The sword for witches. Should I read these now? Probably not. Witch prankings.
Wedymin, rodem z klecht Nordinów, nie do wiary. Szkoda, że nie mam czasu.
We talk to you again?
Racz nie przeszkadzać.
Be so kind and do not disturb. All right. A string, huh? Yeah, dumplings. I can't leave through here yet. All right. Right then, let's put that on. So the boots and trousers are all the same. Usually I go for this one, I think. Let's go with another one this time. This is ugly, but I mean, all of these outfits are. We're ready. Hi, Elias. Going to try the Manticore set. I do have the Manticore set in my storage, so once I'm at my I get to my storage, which might not be before Crow's Perch, right? I'll try it on, yeah.
Trochę za wąsko w talii, ale może być. Czy waszmość jest content ze stroju?
Content byłbym w ćwiekowanej kurtce i z mieczem na plecach. Ale trudno, skoro wpadłem między wrony.
Słucham?
Takie powiedzenie. To co teraz? Będziesz mnie pudrować?
Nie ma potrzeby. Waszmość posiada dostatecznie jasną karnację. Ale nim staniecie przed władcą południa i północy, muszę się upewnić, że waszmość wie, jak się skłonić.
Oh, there's stash in White Orchard? I didn't realize that.
Nie jestem takim chamem, żebym nie wiedział, jak się ukłonić.
To niech waszmość zademonstruje. Tak, proszę waszmości, można co najwyżej ukłonić się kurwie pod latarnią, a nie cesarzowi Nilfgaardu. Proszę patrzeć. Stopa wyciągnięta, dłoń wyprostowana, głowa w dół, aż broda dotknie piersi.
To be honest, I probably
niech waszmość powtórzy.
I probably have more respect for a whore on a street corner than him here, but that's beside the point, I guess. Oh god, guess it was two.
Cóż, ruchom brakuje płynności i gracji, ale po nordlingu mniej się oczekuje. Proszę za mną. Do cesarza waszmość odezwie się tylko na wyraźne życzenie, odpowiednio go tytułując.
Wasza arcymagnificencja?
Widzę, że waszmość w humorze do żartów. Boję się, że cesarz może tej dyspozycji nie podzielać. Wystarczy wasza wysokość. Wypowiedziane głośno, wyraźnie i z szacunkiem.
Majesty. Options 4 and 3. Yeah, I know all the replies, aquatic elk.
Imgrimie ep art herzer, deitven adan in karn ep morwut. Emhyr far Emreis. Ukłon.
Nope.
Wasza cesarska mość.
Areir ep to orde.
Evelien namen vadgen vavort.
Tyle miesięcy na dworze Foltesta, a wciąż nie opanowałeś podstaw etykiety.
Znasz to powiedzenie. Starego psa nowych sztuczek nie nauczysz. Zgaduję, że nie wezwałeś mnie, żeby powspominać stare dobre czasy, więc...
Milcz. Moja córka Cyrilla wróciła. Jest w niebezpieczeństwie. Tropi ją dziki gon. Masz ją znaleźć i przyprowadzić do mnie.
Yeah, you did say so, Elias. I'm definitely gonna try that on. I'll also have a look at how much toxicity bonus the Manticore set exactly gives me. Because I think I'm at 293 or something now, and if it's more than 60 all in all, then that means I can use another decoction. Go up to 5, which would be really neat.
Jesteś pewien? Ciri przecież odeszła. Bardzo daleko.
Myślisz, że wzywałbym cię tu w środku wojny, gdyby to były plotki?
Myślę, że nawet cesarz może się mylić.
Zapomniałem, jaki jesteś bezczelny. Nie mam czasu ani specjalnej ochoty, żeby cię przekonywać. Zrobi to Yennefer. Po audiencji.
They do, don't they, Aquatic? But then again, we don't get Charles Dance in the Polish version for him here.
Ilu ludzi liczy twoja armia? 20 000? 30? Czemu akurat ja?
Wiesz przecież, bo ci ufa.
Ufa, prawda? Więc powiedz, czemu jej szukasz? Przecież nie chodzi o to, żebyście nadrobili stracone lata, prawda?
Chodzi o rację stanu, jak zawsze. Słuchaj, skończmy te podchody i tak się zgodzisz. Choćby dlatego, że ci zapłacę. Więcej niż zwykle bierzesz za zlecenie. Znacznie więcej.
Potrzebuję informacji, nie motywacji. Ciri zostawia mało śladów. Ciężko będzie ją wytropić.
Możesz liczyć na pomoc mojego wywiadu. I wojska, jeśli zajdzie potrzeba. Resztę powie ci Yennefer. Koniec audiencji. Meredith!
Never watched Game of Thrones.
Zaprowadź go do czarodziejki.
Well, I'd say if you like The Witcher, then there's a very good chance you like Game of Thrones too.
Czy wasz mość nie zrozumiał? Czy nie dość wyraźnie podkreślałem, że cesarzowi należy się skłonić?
Spokojnie, nic się nie stało.
Wasz mości nic, prawda? Ale mnie czeka kara.
Jaka kara?
Niech wasz mość trzyma się blisko i nikogo nie zaczepia. Dość łamania etykiety na jeden dzień.
Oh, Merrit. I'm sorry, but I can't bow before that asshole. Wow.
Spokój.
Also, I will bother people, because I need to look around. So they're ripping out the Temerian seals and installing their own ones, I guess.
Jakby mi to robiło różnicę, Her? Domagam się!
Spokój.
Cesarz pracuje w ciszy, a to się kłócą, każe
słuchać. Ah, that was a raspy voice.
Herzer es deitwen adanin karnep morwut.
Wasz mość będzie miał czas na spacery później. Proszę do mnie.
Well, The Witcher has a certain style to it, but hasn't it? If you're more into the, like, fluffy, happy endings, fairy tale stories kind of stuff, then maybe not. Morvran's somewhere here, right? I wanted to talk to him still, for sure.
That's the enenect. Es tu necessar en en fire.
Es es idapsi pe France en en mat. Nen kofurteil an en fadal.
Es vrak, kes side.
Dut, visefara tre spaseb. Detate gan en kalan nes av evalu sar. Eptuson.
Można przerwać?
Zamiast przerywać, dołącz do rozmowy.
Rozmawialiśmy o neutralności. O tym, jak trudno ją zachować.
Yes, it seems it's kind of difficult if an empire is overrunning the whole world, right, guys? I'm more than happy to talk politics.
Mimo wszystko trzeba próbować.
Bo?
Bo mało jest spraw, którym warto służyć, i jeszcze mniej ludzi. Tyle w tej kwestii. Możemy zmienić temat? Jestem już po rozmowie z cesarzem.
I czemu cię wezwał?
Czyli nawet ty nie wiesz.
Nie, ale zgaduję, że chodzi o zwykłe wiedźmińskie zlecenie.
Na bobołaki.
Webups.
Bywaj.
Do rychłego.
Bywaj.
Do czarodziejki?
All right, Merit. We'll go. What the fuck? Are you mouthing off at me? While I'm standing right here? Can't believe it. Oh, that's right. There was... What are they saying?
Imher ord kes vandre slafjet kerden dugas vikovaro glenes plas. Kvandrgalu es anakvas.
That werebub's line. I don't know, I think this garden looks fine, doesn't it? Meh.
Gdy wasz mość skończy, proszę do mnie przyjść po swoje rzeczy.
Piłeś już to pióro? Tak? To zaraz.
Also I need to turn off the current buffs again. Because I want to play without the HUD.
Prawdziwą władzę w Nowigradzie sprawują nie rajcy ani kupcy, tylko Kościół Wiecznego Ognia i przestępcy. Czasem jednych trudno odróżnić od drugich. Cechują się podobną bezwzględnością i cynizmem, a...
Proszę zaczekać, wasza wielmożność, nie nadążam.
Wiesz co, sam sporządzę ten raport. Potem go tylko przepiszesz na czysto. W trzech kopiach.
Racz nie przeszkadzać.
So what exactly? Oh, talk to Yennefer, right? Well, if we can delay that, I'm always happy. She's not exactly a pleasure to talk to, is she? What shall become of Temeria? I think I might be reading a few books, actually. Because I know I read almost everything in my first playthrough, but there were a couple that I didn't get to. And since I'm streaming this for the first time, might as well read it again. Smoking Pipe, Dried Fruit. Also, this guy... Oh, okay, we can only talk to him later then. Well... Let's go over here and read a couple books in our beautiful doublet. Oh, I can't access my inventory. Never mind then. Guess we'll have to talk to her.
Wedymin, rodem z klecht Nordlingów, niedowiary.
Geralt, wyglądasz szałowo w tym kubraku.
Ja tam nie mogę się doczekać, aż go zdejmę.
W innych okolicznościach potraktowałabym to jako propozycję. Może nawet bym z niej skorzystała. Ale mamy co robić.
Jestem
na dworze Emhyra.
I wygląda na to, że płyniemy odtąd na tej samej łodzi. Ciri rzeczywiście wróciła? Nie ma mowy o pomyłce?
Zobacz. Według relacji naszych agentów wygląda teraz mniej więcej tak. Mała wiedźminka wyrosła na niezłą pannicę.
Right. So my instinct always is to be as bitchy as possible with Yen, but I've always done that. So they're our agents now. Let's try the other one.
A niech mnie rzeczywiście wydoroślała.
Trochę lat minęło, odkąd ćwiczyliście razem w Kermoren. Wiele się zmieniło.
Ty nic a nic.
Stęskniłam się za tymi twoimi niezdarnymi komplementami. Ale skupmy się na razie na Ciri, dobrze?
Racja. Emhyr mówił, że idzie za nią dziki gon. Ciężko byłoby mi w to uwierzyć, gdyby nie wczoraj. Jak oni nas wywęszyli?
Przeze mnie. Widzisz, szukam Ciri od miesięcy. Zaklęcia lokalizacyjne, haruspicja, geomancja i tak dalej. Wiedziałam, że dziki gon może to wyczuć i znaleźć mnie. Ale myślałam, że ich oszukam.
Cóż, nie do końca ci wyszło.
Od jakiegoś czasu czułam, że mam ich na karku i że polują na mnie. Gdyby nie ty i żołnierze Emhyra, dopieliby swego. Nie mogę ryzykować kolejnego takiego spotkania. Pora skończyć z szarami namierzającymi, czas sięgnąć po bardziej tradycyjne metody. Po najlepszego tropiciela, jakiego znam. Musisz ją znaleźć, Geralt, zanim zrobi to dziki gon.
Oh, how I've missed these awkward compliments of yours. Not.
Czego dziki gon może chcieć od Ciri?
Nie mam pojęcia, Geralt. Wysłałabym im list z zapytaniem, ale nie znam adresu. Przecież wiem tyle, co ty. Pewnie chodzi im o jej krew. Jej dar. A do czego Ciri miałaby gonowi posłużyć? Wolę nawet o tym nie myśleć.
To gdzie dokładnie widziano Ciri?
W dwóch miejscach. W Velen i w Nowigradzie. Ślad w Velen jest najbardziej obiecujący. Pojedź tam w pierwszej kolejności. W karczmie na rozstajach spytaj o kupca Henryka. To agent cesarza, skontaktuje się z tobą.
I co, tyle? Żadnego hasła, tajnych znaków?
Żadnych tajnych znaków. Przykro mi, że niszczę twoje chłopięce wyobrażenia o pracy wywiadu. Z Nowigradu mamy tylko niesprawdzone informacje, plotki. Ale tam może ci pomóc nasza wspólna znajoma. Niejaka Triss Marigold. Ma ponoć przytulny apartament w kamienicy przy głównym rynku.
Na pewno się ucieszy, jak mnie zobaczy. A ty co będziesz robić?
Wybieram się zaraz na Skellige. Doszło tam do magicznej eksplozji, która zniszczyła pół lasu. I ma chyba coś wspólnego z Ciri. Będę w Kertrolde. Dołącz tam do mnie, jak już się czegoś dowiesz.
Zanim się rozstaniemy, czemu nie odezwałaś się wcześniej? Bo mnie nie potrzebowałaś?
Nie, bo ty mnie nie potrzebowałeś. Słyszałam, że tworzyliście z Triss świetną parę.
Wiem, oh God. Straciłem pamięć.
Naprawdę? To jest twoja wymówka?
That's a pretty good excuse, if you ask me.
Zostawmy lepiej ten temat. Bo jeśli jeszcze usłyszę, to nie tak, jak ci się wydaje, albo dzięki temu zrozumiałem, jak cię kocham, to nie ręczę za siebie.
I wasn't gonna say any of that anyways, so...
No i znów się rozjeżdżamy. Szkoda, ale rozumiem. Czas goni.
Goni, prawda. Więc może od razu teleportujecie do Velen?
O nie, nie ma mowy. Pojadę konno, jak tylko się przebiorę.
Jak wolisz. A tak na marginesie, naprawdę dobrze ci w czarnym aksamicie.
Mówisz? Może oprzyję sobie nim zbroję. Powodzenia, Jen.
I wzajemnie. Słuchaj, jeżeli chcesz się dowiedzieć, co się działo na świecie, gdy włóczyłeś się z Wezemirem po bezdrożach, porozmawiaj z ambasadorem Faratre. To on, o tam. I Geralt, wiem, że jest wojna i tak dalej, ale nie próbuj zostać bohaterem, dobrze? Po prostu sprawdź te ślady i przyjedź do mnie. W jednym kawałku. Będę na ciebie czekać.
Right. Where are you going, Yen? Oh, of course. Is that right? Let's see what happens if we walk in here.
Oh. Widzę portali.
Heh. Oh, this game. It is good on the details, isn't it? Right. Let's talk to the ambassador.
Szkoda, że nie mam czasu.
Ambasador Faratre. Yennefer mówiła, że mogę cię wypytać o bieżące sprawy, wojnę i tak dalej.
Oczywiście. Jeden sługa cesarza nie ma tajemnic przed drugim. Pozwól, podejdźmy do mapy.
Yeah, I like doing that too, Aquatic. Just curious if you can follow her and go right to Skellige. It would be funny if that worked too. How's the war going?
Jak przebiega wojna? Poza tym, że niechybnie doprowadzi do triumfu Nilfgaardu.
Rozmawiamy w cztery oczy, bez świadków. Więc dajmy spokój z propagandą, choćby podszytą ironią. Ofensywa szła świetnie aż do zimy. Rozbiliśmy temerskie wojska w puch. W Edirn był taki chaos, że nikt nie stawiał nam nawet oporu. Przed pierwszymi śniegami dotarliśmy na linię Pontaru. Zostało osłabione Kedwen i Redania Radovida, który ignorował błagania reszty północy o pomoc. Myśleliśmy, że poprosi o pokój, może nawet złoży hołd lenny. Czekaliśmy roztopu w pewni zwycięstwa.
Radovid? Złoży hołd?
Tak, to były płonne nadzieje. Bo Radovid, zamiast słać posłów albo przesunąć wojska w naszą stronę, przebił się przez zaśnieżone góry pustulskie i zaatakował Kedwen, swego sojusznika. Radovid wziął ich z zaskoczenia, a że morale Kedweńczyków i tak było niskie po śmierci ich króla, starczyło kilka przegranych potyczek, by złożyli broń i przeszli na stronę Redanii. I tak na wiosnę, zamiast dwóch słabych wrogów, mieliśmy już tylko jednego, za to potężnego.
A co z Kovirem?
Kovir ceni swoją neutralność. Na tyle, by nie użyczać swoich wojsk, ani co ważniejsze pieniędzy, żadnej ze stron. Wracając do wojny, na wiosnę doszło do wielkiej bitwy na Błoniach Velen. Wielkiej, ale i nierozstrzygniętej. Straty po obu stronach były ogromne, bezprecedensowe wręcz. Radovid wycofał się za Pontar. Póki co jest tam bezpieczny, do czasu aż z południa przybędą posiłki. Wtedy cesarz Emhyr Far Emreis rozprawi się z nim ostatecznie.
A nie moglibyście po prostu wrócić do siebie? Oszczędzilibyście wszystkim Zachodu i sporo ludzkich istnień.
Obawiam się, że stawka jest za wysoka, żeby złożyć karty. Można grać już tylko wabank.
Jak wygląda sytuacja w Velen?
Źle, jak zawsze. Albo nawet gorzej. To nigdy nie była kraina mlekiem i miodem płynąca. A teraz jeszcze spłynęła krwią. Wojska przeszły tamtędy kilka razy. Zadeptały pola, złupiły spichrze, spaliły wsie. Ludzie głodują.
Mhm. I jak wam idzie zarządzanie tym rajem na ziemi?
Nie najlepiej, szczerze mówiąc. Nasze siły i tak są rozciągnięte, a Velen to głównie moczary i gęste lasy. Ciężko kontrolować taki teren. Zdarzało się, że patrole nie wracały do garnizonu. Dlatego tymczasowo władzę w naszym imieniu sprawuje tam pewien Nordling. Niegdyś niższej rangi oficer temerskiej armii Filip Stenger. Znany lepiej pod
Stenger?
Stenger Krwawy Baron. Unikaj go. Dobrze ci radzę.
Did he just misspeak, or is he really called differently? A different name in the Polish version. Philip Stenger instead of Strenger. What's new in Novigrad?
Huh. Jakie wieści z Nowigradu? Wolne miasto wciąż jest wolne?
Tak, chociaż wszyscy wiedzą, tak, że to długo nie potrwa. W Oxenfurcie siedzi Radovid, a cesarz tu w Wyzimie. Za blisko. Obaj potrzebują pieniędzy i większej floty. A Nowigrad może dać jedno i drugie. Dlatego atmosfera w mieście jest dość nerwowa.
To znaczy?
Jak ludzie radzą sobie ze strachem? Szukają pocieszenia i kozłów ofiarnych. Kościół Wiecznego Ognia doskonale to rozumie. Dlatego obiecuje wiernym poprawę losu i wskazuje palcem winnych.
Oh, this game, being topical and all.
Kto na niej zarobi? Wiadomo, czarodzieje, elfy, krasnoludy, słowem odmieńcy. Jestem na placówce w Nowigradzie od 13 lat. Wpierw jako konsul, potem ambasador. Wiele widziałem. Okrucieństwo, cynizm, chciwość. Ale to, co się tam teraz dzieje, przyprawia o dreszcze.
Exchange Novigrad for America. And it still makes sense.
A co nowego na Skellige?
Nic. To jest właśnie duma wyspiarzy, prawda?
robić wszystko wedle tradycji, jak pradziadowie. A zatem tak jak pradziadowie żrą się między sobą, kradną, czasem napadają na nasze transporty. To uciążliwe, ale nic więcej. Skellige zawsze było na marginesie historii i wciąż tam tkwi.
Bardzo jesteś pewien swego. A co jeśli królowi Branowi uda się pogodzić jarlów i poprowadzi ich przeciw waszej flocie?
Król Bran jest zniedołężniałym starcem. Z tego co słyszę, nie pamięta już nawet imion swoich wasali. Więc z tym jednoczeniem może być ciężko.
Dzięki za pomoc.
Nie ma za co. Niechaj wielkie słońce oświeca ci drogę.
Some of you want off Mr. Trump's wild ride, just saying. Oh yeah, I am very aware that, Elias. I am very aware.
Tak, Geralt? Co?
Thanks for your help.
Dzięki za pomoc.
Nie ma za co. Niechaj wielkie słońce oświeca ci drogę.
Any more books I can steal? A sword for witches. Witches get stitches. Why can't I loot here? Rusty bread knife. Great. Oh god. I mean, I might not go all out as much as I did in my first playthrough and actually collect like all letter to Yennefer, we gotta read that. Collect like all the loot on the seas in Skellige, but I'm still gonna be picking up rusty bread knives, I'm sorry. Yennefer, my dear friend, who's writing? Fringilla, oh. Thank you for your letter. Forgive me for not answering your earlier attempt to reach me via megascope. I'm trying to limit my magic communication to the absolute minimum. One never knows who's listening, don't you agree? Exchange megascope for WhatsApp. I'm delighted you have found a position at our gracious Emperor's court, and wish you the best of luck in the search for his daughter. It's good to know that Emhyr's intentions for her have become more, shall I put it, mundane. Perhaps in these circumstances an agreement regarding the lodge will prove possible after all. In response to your first question, I can state beyond all doubt that Ciri has not appeared anywhere south of the Yoruga. Believe me, I could recognize her magic signature in my sleep. I've not had any contact with Triss for a long time. I shall know that things in Novigrad have taken an ill turn. She mentioned something earlier about fleeing to Kovir, but I'm afraid that in the current political climate, that amounts to an impossible daydream. I hope I will soon be able to join you in Wizima. First, however, I must take care of some unfortunate yet urgent matters in Beauclair. With my fondest regards, Fringilla Vigo. Thank you for the news about Geralt. He always seems to land on his feet, doesn't he? That's interesting. I hadn't read this with the Blood and Wine expansion in mind earlier. What's Fringilla Vigo doing in Beauclair? Is there something in the Blood and Wine expansion that mentions her? I'm not sure. But knowing the writers of this game, there probably is some hint regarding it, at least. Royal lineages, the Wild Hunt, and I think that is all. Can we look at Ciri again? Yeah. Pretty good picture. It's lacking her. Yeah, I was about to say, it's lacking the scar, though. Maybe that was just the artist flattering her. Also, what's this? Can we pick this up? Oh, God. Candles, again. Keeping me from picking up my loot. Yeah, I think we might not be able to. All right. Can I access my inventory now? No. There's one more bookshelf. She who knows. Oh, there's most. Wait, how did I overlook all this? The Last Wish, of course. Oh. crafting stuff. Unferte. Horns, dried fruits and nuts. That should be all now though, huh? Yes, yes. Alright.
Jak mogę waszmości służyć?
Oddając moje rzeczy.
Cytrusy i goździk. Dzięki tym perfumom szaty waszmości dłużej zachowają świeżość.
Pięknie dziękuję.
Thanks,
cesarz
bunches.
Nie słynie z cierpliwości. Chcę zobaczyć swoją córkę całą i zdrową. Jak najszybciej.
Ta, wspomniał coś o tym, zdaje się. Bywaj.
Thanks bunches. The way he says that in the English voiceover is actually one of my favorite lines in the game as well. Also, wasn't it day a second earlier? How did it get so dark so soon? Oh, Geralt, you beautiful bastard. Right. Let's get dressed. Still can't wear that. As for swords, of course, Arondite. I promised the Lady of the Lake I wouldn't be losing it again. What am I at? 585 to 715. Damage is increased by 60 to a maximum of 90. Oh, I need to level Arondite quite a bit still. Also, I think I have a... Yeah, I have a point. And yeah, I'm still aware of your build, Elias, and I recognize it is probably better, strictly speaking, but just for like style purposes, I think I want to go for a for using the heavy attacks quite a bit, just because I think it's badass, what with the rend and then the Sundrama as well. And also this Razor Focus, I'm skilling this to increase my adrenaline point gain, and then I want to combine this with Hunter Instinct. When adrenaline points are at their maximum, critical hit damage against the targeted enemy type is increased by 100%, I imagine, at level 5. So yeah, just do a lot of critical swings with the heavy style. And to combine this, or to make this more viable, I also skill Urden a little bit to make enemies slower. I think this could be a fun build. There might be better ones, but I want to go for this one as well. I might at some point also switch to a sign build. I've done that earlier and that was pretty fun too. So we have the Nilfgaardian Connection as a new quest, travel to Velen. And yeah, again, if anyone in chat knows how these quest levels work, please let me know. Are they just fixed for the new game plus? Do they change if you have enemy scaling enabled? Because I do. Because they seem pretty well adjusted to the level I have. And if that was just the level that they had for New Game Plus anyways, then I would be surprised. Because I was like level 53, I think, at the end of the game. And I thought that was pretty high. Yeah. I have a couple of finished quests now. We're not going to read those because I've read all of them before. I think before I leave, I will have a look at the books we have, though. Oh, so we have 4 versions of the Sword for Witches. All right. Only thing that affects them is the level you start NG Plus on. Quests are fixed. Okay, that makes sense. Okay. Who are the hunters, you ask? Folk like you and yours, I reply. The decent kind, haters of lies, doers of good. The kind to live according to the gods' laws, and nature's laws, too. Those disgusted by the PC liberal elite, by the machinations of witches, magickers, and non-humans. All that separates us from common folk is that we've the courage to take up arms, to defend our lands from evil, to slice out the gangrene that eats us from within. Make America great again, also. We haven't a leader, but we do. We haven't forts or land, though God's fearing Radovid supports us with gold at times. We've not sworn him nor any other ruler any oath. We serve only the eternal fire, and we listen only to our own conscience. Funny how prophetic this game almost is, huh? Who can join us? Any who is right of soul and sound of body. You can find us in any larger city of the north. We'll give you board, lodging, and a weapon. We will explain how to spot the telltale signs of evil, birthmarks in strange and arcane shapes. Smooth skin on a matron aged more than 30 springs. And black cats kept in the yard, to name but a few. We'll show you how to defend yourself from witchcraft, how to tame and snuff out magical elements with dimeridium. We'll instruct you how to squeeze the sinner's darkest secrets out of them with a hot iron. Torture! And how to grant them cleansing death with the help of sacred fire. Gnomish prankings. For something more lighthearted, I guess. Scrub the greasings from a dog's ear, soak into cotton wine, twine. Place in a new lamp of greenish hue, and set said lamp betwixt an eager crowd. Forsooth shall they swear that a dog's head they behold, and this shall be no sorcery, but good betidings. For the prince of Elander's nuptials, a paltry gnome arrived, armed with a miniature cutlass behind himself in a pie. When guests partook of the princely banquet, anon jumped out of the besser-bred gnome, giving a terrible fright to all at first, then causing much merriment once the jest was figured. A cynocephalus, or doghead in our tongue, a beast that in the wastes of Zangibar dwells, has the corpus of a man but the head of a dog. The prince of Elanda did receive such a specimen from those far-off lands. The cynocephalus lets stream its urine with a tolling of every hour, but day and night, both day and night, and this is why the Zangibarians engrave its likeness on timepieces and compasses. Then we got the wonders of Zarikania. Oh, I wish we'd go to Zarikania in Witcher 3. We could go there. Probably be an interesting land to see. During my many travels, I've seen countless extraordinary places. The primeval wilds of Broccolon, with trees so high their tips disappear in the clouds. Dwarven chambers carved into the guts of the Mahakam Mountains, with walls plated in pure gold. The ice palace of Pond Venice, adorned with stained frost windows. Yet none of these made such an impression on me as did the rightly famed Zarikania. Yet while I was traversing the fiery mountains, I feared disappointment awaited me on the other side. I heard many a fantastic tale about Zarikania, about its trackless sands burnt white by the sun, its golden-scaled dragons weaving their nests amidst the dunes, its hunchbacked horses able to survive weeks without even a swallow of water, yet none seemed to be at all plausible. It was sure all these sensations were but the figments of some bard's overactive imagination. I know this will be hard for you to believe, dear reader, as it once was for me, but all of the unbelievable tales are true. Not only that, during my many months of travel, I came across wonders far surpassing those of any prior travelogues mentioned. I saw temples dedicated to the worship of dragons. I heard their voice, almost human, but reverberating with 1,000 echoes. Fusroda. I met warrior maids clad in leopard skins, tattooed from head to foot and giving no ground to witches in mastery of the blade. I saw mages who channeled power from fire. I saw seemingly harmless flies whose solitary bite would make a man fall into a deep slumber, never to awake, save to die. In short, Zarikania is a land where the fantastic is normal and the impossible occurs daily. The opposition in Nilfgaard. Well, Nilfgaard's emperor wields absolute power, harshly crushing the slightest sign of disobedience. So, Nilfgaard's emperor is Hillary, and the opposition in Nilfgaard is Bernie, right? Opposing forces continue to exist within the empire. Or the DNC. By this, I do not mean the disgruntled leaders of conquered provinces, but the magnates within the City of 1,000 Towers who are unhappy with the current leadership. The conflict between the emperor and the noble houses of Nilfgaard, the capital, dates back many years. All the princes of the blood and magnates expected their ruler to wed one of their daughters and sire on and sire an heir with one of their own. The emperor, however, had other plans. This proved a slap in the face of all the great families from which he refused to take a bride. The Nilfgaardian opposition patiently waits for the emperor to slip up, for some event to occur which will weaken his authority, be it an economic crisis or a defeat in an election. A secret conspiracy lies ready to seize much of a moment to incite the disaffected, assassinate the emperor and carry out a coup d'etat, culminating with one of their own number ascending to the throne. If only. For obvious reasons, only a limited few know of this conspiracy, but any shrewd observer of Nilfgaardian politics can read the signs of this of his workings. So long as men are men and the world is as it is, certain dynamics will forever remain the same, and the discontented will always form subversive societies with their secret signs and hidden agendas. Also, I think the Moat comparison here is that Ciri is Bernie, right? Right, guys? Which is why she has to become Empress of Nilfgaard. The Chronicles of Redania. Redung the Elf. Despite what one might conclude from his moniker, not one drop of elven blood flowed in King Vridung's veins. They called him the Elf because of his exceptional beauty and for the great admiration he felt for the Enshade. His fascination, seemingly harmless, would have horrible long-term consequences. King Vridung, spitting in the face of all laws and customs, chose as his wife a half-elf, and one of low status at that, known as Beatrix of Covia. The fruit of his regrettable and short-lived mésalliance was Falca, who later fomented bloody revolt against her own father, though his uprising was ultimately extinguished and Falca herself burned at the stake. The young state was thereafter thrown into chaos for years to come. Falca's Rebellion, also an interesting story. Pearls of the North, Novigrad. No one can claim to have traveled the northern realms who has not been to Novigrad. If I were forced to list what during my many meanderings has made the greatest impression on me, it would be precisely this great and yet at the same time free city. Metropolis worthy of the Empire, its only flaw is that the civilization Nilfgaard carries within her has not yet enlightened it. That is why hordes of reactionary cultists of the Eternal Fire dwell in the midst of this its excellent buildings and superb commercial infrastructure. One feels as though superstition is how the local hierarch and his temple guards cement their power over the city dwellers, and many there are to control, for the city counts no less than 30,000 of inhabitants. 30,000, I guess. While strolling through its fabulous port, surrounded by marvels of architecture, it is hard to imagine that centuries ago Novigrad was a mere minor elven townstead. When the city fell into the hands of the Nordlings, its problems grew exponentially, for as is well known, the people of the North can do a great many things, but peaceful and orderly cohabitation is not one of them. And so Novigrad first belonged to Redania and then fell under Temerian rule, until finally, after endless compromises and bargains, it is at last a free city. But is this city truly free? I dare to doubt it. Redanian influence makes itself felt too strongly on every street corner. The fact that the city is located within Radovid's territory speaks for itself. While wandering the city streets, I came across 4 watermills, 8 banks, and nearly 19 pawn shops. There are also a great many houses of simple pleasures, such as taverns and brothels, and Novigrad's commitment to matters of faith is borne witness by the fact that the city contains no less than, I kid you not, 19 temples to the Eternal Fire. What more can be said? I think Novigrad has all the makings of the capital of the world, and perhaps that is what it will one day become. First, however, someone needs to bring order to within her walls. Yeah, I think it's interesting and cool that all the kind of political texts we find in this palace from an Nilfgaardian point of view. Makes sense, right? What shall become of Temeria? Temeria, a land where milk and honey once flowed. In what did she wrong the gods that they should treat her so cruelly? The Pearl of the North to some, she proved a galloping range for Nilfgaardian cavalry to others. As a country, it had survived 2 previous wars against the Empire. It was here that the war's bloodiest battles were fought. It was in Temeria where the most bestial deeds were wrought. was Temerian civilians who bore the full brunt of these war's horrors. And bear them we did, bravely and steadfastly, until the demise of our great protector, King Foltest. Then Providence turned its fickle face from Temeria. Murdered most treacherously, Foltest failed to leave Temeria a worthy successor. And so all manner of curs soon fell upon her, tearing her apart like so much carrion. She had no more allies then, none remembered that we had once been the armor protecting the north from the designs of the mad dancer, who had the gravestones of its foes pounded into a ballroom door, floor. A free and independent Temeria is no more. A dark-faced sun looms over her every rampart. Yet we Temerians live on, and always will. As long as folk believe, the usurper who took our beloved capital, Wizima, to treat as his property will forever peer over his shoulder in fear. For in the shadows lurks not one dagger, but the power of a nation of daggers, waiting to deal justice's blow. So interestingly, this is from a Temerian point of view, but I guess it makes sense to find a couple of these texts still in Wizima, right? Royal Lineages of the North. Well, that's about Ciri. Cirilla Fiona Ellen Rhiannon, born in 1251, heiress to the throne of Sintra, princess of Brugge, and duchess of Sodden, heiress to Inizard Skellig and Inizan Skellig, and Suzeraine of Atre and Abjara, daughter of Pervetta, see Pervetta Fiona Ellen, and the urchin of Erlenwald, see Emhyr var Emreis, granddaughter of the famous lioness of Sintra, Queen Calante, see Calante Fiona Rhiannon. A shipwreck occurred during a journey from Sintra to Skellige, which took the lives of the urchin and Pervetta. Cirilla's further upbringing was then entrusted to her grandmother. In 1260, afraid of the looming Nilfgaardian threat, Queen Calante sent Cirilla to the court of King Ervil, see Ervil of Verdun, where the heiress of Sintra was to marry the heir to the throne of Verdun, Prince Kistrin, see Kistrin of Verdun. Though allying with Verdun and gaining the aid of that realm's army was at the time Calante's top priority, no marriage ever occurred, and Cirilla returned to her grandmother's court. In 1262, so at age 11, during the so-called Sintra massacre, Cirilla went missing. And then we have three more, I think? No, six more. A portrayal of the elder races. Oh, that's some racist drivel, isn't it? What is a non-human? The answer is simple. As the very name suggests, it is something which resembles and yet nevertheless is not a human. Though it walks on two legs, speaks a tongue similar to our own, and dresses in similar attire, it all the same has more in common with base beast than noble man. Dwarves are like moles. They feel best underground and avoid direct sunlight. They like to live in filth, forever smudging themselves in mud and slime. They love everything that can be found within the earth, rocks, metal, minerals, and all shape and color. It is also said that, like their kindred moles, they feed most readily on worms, roaches, and other night crawlers. Halflings, for their part, are more reminiscent of gophers, fat, lazy, and loud in the typical rodent way. Their minds are filled with only thoughts of food and drink, which they steal from other nobler beasts and greedily squirrel away in their hovels. They are marked by cruel craftiness. You could be dying of hunger and they would not share a meal with you. You could be howling from poverty and they could be swimming in gold, and yet they would still fleece you to the last crown. You could do nothing but good to them and they would still stab a knife in your back. Elves, in turn, seem related to the birds of prey that dwell in far-off Zarikania. They care for colored feathers. They would most readily spend all day staring at their reflections in the water and sing their own praises. They're so awash in self-love that they no longer feel any desire towards members of the opposite sex of their own species. Their appearance, unquestionably pleasant to the eye, is highly misleading, for they're extraordinarily cruel, and any who judge them by looks alone, they first dupe and then kill in cold blood. The best proof of this? The so-called Skoyatel. Bandits that claim to fight for freedom, but in truth only long to kill humans. All these vile so-called elder races are, to our great fortune, slowly dying out. Joy fills the heart of every right-thinking man at the thought that his great-grandchildren will never know them, that in their day dwarves, halflings, and elves will be mere fairy-tale characters used to scare young, impressionable children. The collected verse of Gonçalves de Verceau. Love and Tide. Love. To love is to build a house of cards or play a game of chess. But one wrong word or ill-thought move, and you must start it all afresh. Tide. Whenever I watch the tide recede, cool coils a fear grip around my heart. Will the sea sneak back calm and sure, in the dark of night as they have before? Will they stay on distant shores, leaving crushed shells and washed-up dreams as memory of serfs of yore? Very poetic. The Wild Hunt, that's what this game is called. From farmers and herdsmen, milkmaids to midwives, all the common folk of the continent whisper, sharing tales of a wraithly procession pounding across the sky. The Wild Hunt, they call it. Winds and gales, storms and blizzards arise when it is sighted. And all grows cold, though the sun shone bright moments before. Some remember only the cold from the shock of the encounter, and claim the riders come always in winter. But nay, this is not so. The hunt brings its own eyes. Death and war gallop in its wake, and so the superstition goes. Yet evil enough is the hunt itself. It takes folk captive, youths most often, in the prime of their wilding years, with 10 to 20 summers behind them. The hunt rushes in, and they disappear, only to return long years later, with no memory of what passed in the time between. She Who Knows. And The Last Wish. Folks say there were four at first. The mother, She Who Knows, the Lady of the Wood, came here from a faraway land, and since she suffered terribly from loneliness, she made three daughters out of dirt and water. Long time ago, the mother was sole ruler of all of Velen. Her daughters brought her the people's requests and served as her voice. Each spring, sacrifices of grain, animals, and men were made to the Lady of the Wood and her special knight. Yet as the years passed, the Lady of the Wood slipped deeper and deeper into madness. Her madness eventually spread over the land. Men took to abandoning their homes and setting out into the bog, where they became food for beasts. Before long, Velen was drowning in blood. The daughters saw their land nearing destruction and took it upon themselves to save it. When spring came once more, and with it the night of sacrifices, they killed their mother and buried her in the bog. Her blood watered the oak atop Art Serbin, and from then on the three grew wholesome and hearty fruit for the people. As for the lady's immortal soul, it refused to leave its beloved land, and so the sisters imprisoned it. To this day it lies trapped beneath a whispering hillock, where threshes about in powerless rage. Threshes. All right, that's actually going to be relevant for one of the quests we're doing for the crones later on. So the three sisters are apparently the crones. And the soul trapped beneath the whispering hillock is the Lady of the Wood, their mother. And lastly, the Last Wish, which is about Yennefer, I would imagine. Human life requires three things for its sustenance: food, drink, and gossip. Oh, is that so? It is thus no wonder that no matter where I travel, be it icebound Povis or evergreen Toussaint, everyone asks me about the passions that bind Geralt and the sorceress Yennefer of Vengerberg. As a man both cautious and discreet, I refuse to betray their secrets, with one important exception. The history of their first encounter is so extraordinary, so romantic and moving, that it would be a veritable crime to hide its light beneath a bushel basket. Indeed, had I not witnessed these events in person, I would never believe there was room in our grim and dark world for such a fantastic marvel. This is written by Dandelion, isn't it? It all began when Geralt and I were feeling a bit peckish and, unburdened by heavy coin pouches, decided to fish our supper out of a lake. No bites were to be had, but we did not leave empty-handed. My hook snagged quite a lovely little pot. Oblivious to my friend's warnings, I opened it, and in doing so freed a powerful din. Without giving it much thought, I set about proclaiming my wishes. Before I could get to three, however, the din irritated, I see now in hindsight, being issued demands so soon after waking, began to throttle me. Geralt was able to drive him off, but I was left in a sorry state. I acted, the witch told me later, as though under the influence of some curse. Clearly, the help of an expert in the magic arcana would be needed. It was our good fortune that Yennefer of Vengerberg happened to be staying in a nearby village. Geralt went to her to ask that she heal his best friend, who happened also to be the brightest star in the Norse poetic firmament. Yennefer, however, was more interested in the djinn, which she wanted to trap into Medrick's servitude, than in its victim, and, it should be said, played the Witcher like a well-strung mandolin. Yet rather than grow angry at being used in such a calculating manner, he fell white head over muddy boots in love with her. Isn't it romantic? Being used and all. What happened then? Well, I won't go into the details. Suffice it to say that Yennefer's plans hardly delighted the djinn, and without its cooperation, she proved unable to tame it. The sorceress would surely have met a tragic end and taken all of Rind along with her. Geralt not rushed to her rescue. For once, he did not need to draw either of his blades to send the djinn packing. He had but to pronounce the third and final wish. Could have asked for anything, wealth, fame, power, but instead he asked the djinn to bind his fate to that of the arrogant yet intriguing sorceress from Vengerberg. Julian Alfred Pancratz, Viscount of Lettenhove, born 1232, award-winning poet, playwright, and troubadour, frequent performer at the courts of Niedermeer, Wizimir, Wenslaw, and many other nobles and notables, alumnus of Oxenford Academy. Also, if he's born in 1232, he's 40 today, isn't he? I think this game is set in 72. So that should be all. Read everything. Yennefer's letter, brother missing. Yeah, we've read all that. Okay, then. Silver monocle. Oh, also, we couldn't mention the crystal skull to... We couldn't give that to Yennefer. Can we do that later still? I hope so. Anyhow, now that we've read all that... This is the Gwent guy. No, this is the Gwent guy, right?
Chcę grać w karty.
I don't know if we have a chance here, because it reset all our Gwent cards as well. Let's see what we have. Yeah. Yeah. I think our deck is as good as it gets with these cards. Geralt is 90-ish. Yeah, I know. So do I want the decoy? Probably, right? I don't want the siege expert, that's better. And I think I don't want Lyafin. That is a little better. Especially if he plays spies. Yeah, that's right. We can use our decoy for that. Let's play a spy ourselves for now. What do we get? Oh, we get the medic. That's pretty good. What was that? Look at three random cards from your opponent's hand. That's pretty bad. So I guess we'll use the decoy on the medic even, right? And then use the medic to get him back. It's probably more efficient. How do I do this? I could play Sabrina to keep him playing in this round. Okay, Fringilla. Do I want the fog? I mean, it's not great for me at the moment, but I do need to bait him into playing more cards. Alright. I mean, I guess I'll get the spy back and hope he plays another spy that I can use my medic on later on as well. I mean, just want him to keep playing cards for now. Right, give you this one. Oh, we get another blue stripes. That's good. Okay, he's passed. So if I want, how much are these gonna be? These are gonna be worth 12 each, right? So that's like 36 points. It's too much. 15. Oh no. Yeah, I mean, I could do the fair weather, and then I'd be plus 5, plus 3, so 20. So I would need 20 points. Yeah, that works. Right. Got vest, that's okay. My turn. Well, I probably want to lose this next round. Also, who do I have to revive? Currently, no one really good. I'd love to bait a spy out of him this round. I might want to keep that though. Let's just do the siege engineer. Nah, he's not playing his spies yet. Okay, there's a spy. That's good, okay. So now we can apple this one. Do I want to do this to get one more card out of him? I should probably keep it just in case he ruins my day with weather next turn. Also, we're at 10, he's at 3, so he needs to spend a couple cards to win this round. Oh god, he has a letho. At least he had to play it here. Okay. So, let's hope this works. Oh god! A 10 and a help. Yeah, well, that's just great. He'll probably crash. He'll probably just crash us now. Let's do the spy nonetheless. I mean, we do still have 36 points in the blue stripes here. And another medic. That's rough. Okay. Yeah, I was expecting as much. A good thing I still have the weather card. Okay, that's not too bad. Mm-hmm. Four cards left, he'll probably kick our ass. That's not so bad. Okay, let's see. This gets us up to 58, so if he doesn't have 10 in his hand, then we win. He probably does, though. Ah, fuck! Alright. Yeah, this is a tough opponent. I guess we'll have to come back later. It was a close one, though. Alright. In that case, I guess we go on to Velen. Wait, where's the exit? Here.